Going on, everyone. Welcome, Rabid here, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how to install WSL2 into your Windows PC. And you're probably asking, why would I want to do that? So this is so you can utilize a Linux subsystem within Windows, and that'll allow you to mine coins such as Cubic as well as Zealous with your GPUs. All right, so I do got my capture card hooked up to a different PC that I want to set up for this because I already did it on my workstation. So the first thing you're going to need to do is make sure Windows has the features enabled. So you're going to go to the little search bar down here, and we're going to type in add features, and it should pop up here. Turn Windows features on or off. Now, by default, most of these are probably off, but you never know. Always make sure you check because maybe they are on. But here we got, we're gonna need to utilize Windows subsystem for Linux. So make sure you do check this. And then also make sure you have virtual machine platform checked as well. Once you do that, you're gonna hit okay if they were turned off. And it's gonna ask you, it's gonna search for some files and stuff. And then it's gonna ask you to reboot. That is a good thing because you are gonna have to reboot. And then we're gonna have to tell our CPU to add virtual utilization. So if it doesn't ask you and you already had that, make sure you do then go in and restart your PC and load it up in the BIOS. All right, so here I am in my BIOS. Now, depending on your version, it's gonna be in a different place. But the first thing you gotta do is you're either gonna have to hit F2 or F7 to get into your advanced mode. So for ASUS, you're gonna come into your advanced setting here, and you're gonna look for your CPU configuration, which is right here. Scroll down till you find SVM mode. I already enabled this here, but this is where you find it. This is what enables and disables CPU virtualization. If you are on an MSI motherboard, I do believe it's in the OC section. And then where you have your RAM settings and overclock settings for your actual CPU, you're gonna go in there and look for extra CPU settings, and your SVM should be located there. As for the motherboards, I'm not sure, but what you're looking for is your SVM. VM mode must be enabled. This is off by default. Once you do that, simply hit F10, make sure you save all your changes, and then reboot back into Windows. All right, so you should have your CPU set up now for virtualization. You should have the necessary files and Windows ready to go. If you want, you can also update your Windows so you don't have to worry about Windows updates later on while you're doing all this stuff. But next up, we're gonna go into PowerShell here. So we're gonna go PowerShell. I'm going to right click on it, and you're going to want to run this as an administrator right there. So yes, we're running as an admin. Now we've got our little PowerShell window up. So we're going to go in, and I'm going to set it so we're going to use WSL2. So I'm going to type in WSL. We're going to go space dash dash set default version 2. Then we're going to hit the enter button and say, for information on key differences with WSL2, please visit this website. The operation completed successfully. Now, we may have to download something in a bit, but we'll know in a second depending on the version of Windows that you are on. So next, we're going to pick our Linux distribution. So I am going to go WSL, and then we're going to go dash dash list. Again, dash dash online. And this will give us a list of what you actually want to install here. And I messed that up. Let's do this again, WSL, because my stomach was in the way there, so I apologize. Dash dash list, dash dash online. Do the command properly and you won't get errors, as you can see here. So now we're gonna pick what we want. So I'm gonna go as the same thing as HiveOS beta. I'm gonna be using and installing 20.04. So this is pretty simple. We're gonna go WSL, then we're gonna go dash dash install. Dash D for distribution. That's where we're going to pick what version and what we want to install here. And I'm simply going to highlight 20.04 here, right click, and then I'm going to right click again down here and put it in. Now I'm going to hit enter. It's going to begin installing, and this is going to tell us if we're going to have to download something extra or not. You may already have this in your Windows system from running previous programs or commands before, or you may not. For me, I'm about to find out if I need it or not. All right, so I am glad that I got the error that I need that file. So it's a simple fix because I'm sure a lot of you guys are going to need it as well. My workstation already had it, so I didn't have to do this step. But you can see here, error, whatever, WSL2 requires an update to its kernel. So for more information, just click right here. So what we're going to do here is we're just going to copy this like so, right click, and now I'm just going to bring that up into a browser, and we're going to go to it and simply download a quick program. So I'm going to paste this in right here. Like so, We're going to come up to a website. Now, all we got to do is simply click on this right here. It's going to download it in the top right corner. As we can see up here, one download is currently in progress. Once that's done, all we got to do is click on it, install it, and we'll be good to go. Let's let it finish up here. There we go. So I'm going to click on this. It's going to do its thing. Yep. Next. Yep. We're going to go. Yep. And now it's going to do its thing. Yes. Finished. We're done. So now we're just going to close this out and we're going to reinstall this again. So now I'm just going to simply come in and do the same command that we did right here. So I'm just going to copy this right here. And I'm just going to paste that right there. And we're just going to hit enter. And now it should finish the installation completely and we should be good to go. It'll ask for a username, password, you know, set up your Ubuntu stuff. All right, so we successfully made it to the next step. Enter new Unix username. So this is the username you want to use. So I'm just going to go rabidmining in this case, like so. Now we're going to have to enter a password. So I'm going to put in my password here. As we can see, everything is all done. Now we successfully have Linux, Ubuntu, the version we installed, inside of Windows. So now you can just close this out as well, and we can just come back into a PowerShell. Whenever you want to run it, you would simply come in, go PowerShell. Once you search it a couple times, it should pop up. Run this as an administrator. Yes. And now I'm just going to type WSL, and it should go to our Linux. There we go. We're all set to go. Now you can run anything in Linux on Windows if you need. So hopefully this guide did help you out. I will see you on the next one. Rabid out.